Well, she say no one is mistreating her. Racism is about mistreatment. Now, is she saying that she perceives she is being mistreated, but she can't put it into words or what? Mistreatment is mistreatment. Most people, babies, I mean, 4-year-olds, know when you can perceive when some mistreatment is going on. So if there's no mistreatment, then there's no mistreatment on that job. All right? Now, racism runs the entire world, but within the context, if people call you on a job and give you the job, and they say you do this and you do that, and you'll be rewarded, you'll be compensated, then, you know, and they don't do anything to interfere with you on the job or take something from you that you're entitled to, then where is the mistreatment? I mean, if you are just uncomfortable, well, that's nothing you can accuse anybody else of. You're just uncomfortable on the job, and you should ask yourself why you are uncomfortable. You can't ask anybody else that, because if you say there's no mistreatment and no one is taking anything away from you or sealing you off from anything that you think you're entitled to, then you have a situation where you're not being mistreated in that particular situation. Now, overall, worldwide, when you consider the existence of racism, you're mistreated from the day that you were born if you're non-white, because you're born in a prison system called the system of white supremacy. That's a given. But within the rules and regulations that they give in that prison, and you're assigned to a certain job in the prison, and they say that, well, now, what constitutes mistreatment for anybody, white or non-white, on this job would be this, this, and this.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if none of those things are happening to you, then why are you uneasy? I mean, just do your job, and that's it. Collect your paycheck. I guess that's what you came there for. Now, if you came there for someone to like you, and sometimes people do, sometimes people like to socialize, they call it,
yes,
on the job.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you weren't hired on the job unless you were hired on the job for socializing. If that's not a part of the job description, you must socialize. And then somebody needs to describe what they mean by socialize. Do you get on the top of the desk and do a hula dance or what? What do they mean by socializing? There are some jobs where they say you must be able to interact with people in a relaxed or laid-back manner, some type of vague language like that. That needs to be nailed down to specifics. What do they want you to do? Do they want you to play a banjo or what? All right? And if that's not in your job description and all like that, just go to the job, say good morning to people, good evening, do your job, and leave. You came there primarily to get a paycheck. That's most jobs. That's what you're there for, to do the job and get compensated for doing the job that you're assigned to do. Now, the socialization, sometimes people, you know, say, and I've heard black people say that, well, nobody wants to talk to me. Nobody wants to laugh and talk to me. I like to laugh and talk. Well, if that's not in the job description, then you really can't ask for that as a requirement.
Mm-hmm.
Laughing and talking.